So the quiz we just did shows that adding more cores might result in a slowdown if we have to stay within the same power budget. But this is only true if we cannot adjust the voltage and frequency so that when there is no parallelism available, we boost the frequency of the one or two active cores so that they get the full power budget of the chip. Modern processors do this. Let's look at an example of Intel's Core i7-4702MQ, which was released in the second quarter of 2013. It's a mobile processor, so its design power is only 37 watts. That's what we can cool in a laptop, apparently. It has four cores, and its normal clock when using all four cores is 2.2 gigahertz maximum. It can actually save power because it might operate on a battery by reducing this frequency even when running all four cores. But the processor has a turbo frequency of 3.2 gigahertz when running only one core. That frequency is 1.45 times the normal frequency. If we assume that the power increases cubically with this, then we would get 3 times the power. So we are not using 4 times the power of a single core, which we should be able to get because it's four cores. So when operating 1/4 of the cores, that 1/4 of the cores can get 4 times the power. We're only getting 3 times. So the question is, why not 4 times? Well, because it's not only about the overall chip power. What's really happening is that if we have a relatively large chip and we have 4 cores on it, let's say, and we keep heating up this part of the chip, the heat will spread into other parts of the chip, but this one will still be hotter than the others. So if we're spending power evenly across the chip, we can spend more power than if we spend it all in one corner of the chip. Because if we spread the power around, then the chip overall gets hotter. If we spend all power in the same place, then that place gets a lot hotter than before. So that's why 3 times and not 4 times. Because at 3 times the power, this part of the chip achieves similar temperatures to those achieved by spreading the heat around at 2.2 gigahertz. Let's look at another example, which is Intel's Core i7-4771. It's a similar processor released in third quarter of 2013, so they're relatively similar in terms of technology and so on. But this is not a laptop processor. Its design power is much higher at 84 watts. It also has 4 cores, but the normal clock of a core is now 3.5 gigahertz, much larger than in the mobile processor. The turbo clock, when running only one core, is 3.9 gigahertz, or only 11% above normal. And if we assume that the power is cubically growing with frequency, that means it's only spending 1.38 times the power of a core when working with 3 other cores. Why is it like that? Well, because this, being a non-mobile processor, has much better cooling, so it can cool the chip when operating at this high power. But that also means that the chip is already pretty hot, and getting it even slightly hotter in any place very quickly reaches the temperatures at which it's dangerous for the chip. So we could only really spend this much more power in one core, even though the others are not working. So pretty much what's happening is, when running at 4 cores, the chip is very close to not being able to cool. If we turbo boost a particular part of the chip, it gets even hotter, and we can only afford a little bit more of heat before we run into cooling issues. Even though the heat is kind of leaking to the cooler parts of the chip, it's just not doing it enough. And this is pretty typical, that cores designed for lower power have more flexibility in shifting that power, whereas if we are near the limits of what we can do, then really shifting the power so that it can all be consumed in one corner very quickly gets that one corner of the chip to overheat.